Love is a blessing from above that we all wish for. Love from our family, friends, and a special someone. On this hill, a very special love was born that could never be denied. Even when Danielle and Caterina were kids, they were inseparable. As the two of them grew older, the close friendship they share gradually turned into love. A love so complete, it cannot be measured nor surpassed. A love that is forever.
Oh, hi.
Hi.
Hi, John.
How are you?
I'm good.
I'm fine.
Oh, hello, Jane. How are you?
Hello.
Your daughter keeps getting lovelier every time.
She's not only pretty, but also smart. And not only that, John made her manager of the bank's Olivares City branch.
That's right.
Oh, that's good news. That's a very well-deserved promotion.
Thanks. Isn't it?
Come on, let's all go inside.
Okay, let's go. You have a very beautiful house. And you serve the best wine. What is this I'm drinking?
Penfold's Grange.
You have excellent taste.
Oh, it wasn't me. The wine that we are all drinking tonight was chosen by Marco.
What's that noise? Oh, what was that? What do you think you're doing?
Don't mind that. Let's go.
When preparing for a party like this, be careful how you season your food. Don't put too much salt. Let the guests decide how to season their food. And be careful with the cheese, too.
Yes, ma'am.
You might end up putting too much. And for our callos, take out the brandy. Before we serve this, let's put in some brandy so it's tastier.
Congratulations. Your party's a big success.
Oh, thank you. See you around.
Okay.
Ma'am?
Where's Marco? I asked him to fetch something for me inside the house. Don't you worry, dear. Your boyfriend is on his way.
Yes, thank you. And for my friends as well.
Sure, sir. Ma'am Henya, these are the girls who will help out in the party.
Good evening, Ma'am Virginia.
Yes, good evening, girls.
More helpers are coming. Our companions just went to get them, but they're on their way.
Oh, thank you. Come with me.
We need attendants for the buffet table.
Oh, yes. They're already here. They just have to go and change.
Come on. Go ahead.
You will help man the buffet table, okay?
Hey, Kenneth. I want you to behave. Don't cause any trouble.
Marco, it's about time.
Oh, Mom, I'm sorry. I'll make it up to you.
Your girlfriend has been waiting for you all night, Marco. It's embarrassing.
It's okay. You're beautiful, Mom. I'll have one. Hello.
Hi.
Sir Marco's really so handsome. No wonder a lot of girls are smitten by him.
You look really good tonight.
Even if he doesn't have a girlfriend, do you think he'll pay attention to us? Of course not.
Is it okay?
Yes.
Good. Sir, yes.
You have to try this. This is a Chateau de Tour from Rio Grande Cru.
Mmm. Nice bouquet.
How is it?
It's very smooth.
Oh, good, right?
Where did you get this?
Chateau de Thou is from the Bordeaux region in France.
Hmm. I think this is even better than the other one.
Really?
Well, when it comes to wine, no one is better than my son Marco. Don't you agree, John?
I agree 100%.
Which brings me to this new business I'd like to venture in. Why don't we talk?
Why not?
Let's go.
What kind of business is that? Do you need a loan? No problem. I'll approve it at once.
You haven't even seen the proposal. You'll approve it already?
I will do anything for you, Marco. No questions asked. You won't get any arguments from me.
How come you don't oppose me anymore?
It's because I love you.
You know what? You're perfect for me. No, you're too perfect for me.
Do you want to take a walk through the garden?
Go ahead. I just have to get something. Okay?
Miss Emily, let me bring that dish out, please.
No, Kenneth. I'm sorry.
Please, Miss Emily. I just want to go out to see all the guests. I heard they're all very rich. I want to see their beautiful clothes and sparkling jewelry. Please, Miss Emily.
I'm the one who'll get in trouble if I let you.
Killjoy.
Friend, you should try my Kalia's dish.
Did you cook it yourself?
Why, of course I did.
Oh,
come on, let's try it.
Okay, let's go. Oh, my gosh. I'm so sorry, Madam Margaret.
Margaret,
I
don't
know what you should do.
I'm okay. I'm okay.
Come on,
are you
sure?
I'm okay, yes. In fact, I was about to change anyway.
Come on.
Go ahead, enjoy the party. Enjoy yourselves. I'm okay. Enjoy the party. Never mind, there's nothing to see here.
I'm so sorry.
Stop it. I want you to leave this house at once. I don't want to see your face again. You are so stupid. This night was a disaster! I was humiliated!
Look, they all know it was an accident.
You don't understand me. I did grow up rich like they did. It took a lot of hard work for me to finally be one of the elite. And even when we became as rich as they are, up to now, I know they still don't consider me as one of them.
That's enough. You're being paranoid.
No, I'm sure of it.
Margaret. Forget about what happened earlier. You're going to compose yourself, then go back to the party. Okay?
Okay, Joseph. Marco? Marco?
Mom! Wait, just a minute. No, I'm coming back to the party shortly.
All right. Don't be too long, okay?
This will be quick, Mom.
Oh, hey, miss. Wait up. Here's your pay. You haven't gotten it yet.
Oh, no. I wasn't able to finish the night anyway.
Oh, well, even so, that doesn't matter. You still worked for a few hours.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Wait, what's your name again? I forgot it.
Emily, ma'am. I'm really sorry about what happened earlier. I didn't mean it. I wish I could just talk to Ma'am Margaret so I can apologize to her properly.
Oh, forget it. I know Margaret. I'm sure she doesn't want to talk to you or even see you. Oh, don't worry. I'll let her know that you are sorry.
Thank you very much, ma'am. I'll go ahead.
All right, my dear.
Ma'am Virginia, have you seen Marco?
Huh? I thought you two were together. Oh, come on. Let's look for
him. Oh, no. He might be talking to someone important. It's late anyway. I'll ask Mom and Dad if we can go home now. Okay.
All right. I'll accompany you.
It's a good thing you didn't ask me where your boyfriend is.
I'm sorry about last night. A lot of people wanted to talk to me.
It's okay. I understand.
I also have a lot of Quran trees planted here. I still want to add some more, so I bought the neighboring estate. By the way, Marco will be in charge of this new business venture. Okay.
You know that I admire you and Joseph's business sense. But Quran, there's not really a big market for that.
But I will use it for another venture. Wine making.
Quarant wine?
Yes, Quarant wine. In fact, we are already fermenting several bottles in our storeroom.
But how good is it? Will it be able to compete with imported labels like this one?
Why, John? Is that wine delicious?
Yes, but I'm not familiar with this.
It was Marco who produced that. That's Quarant wine.
That's impressive, Marco. You're truly a genius when it comes to winemaking.
Thank you, sir.
And with the loan that you will be giving us for this venture, I can buy all the machineries as well as all the equipments to produce the wine.
Joseph.
Yes?
You're really lucky to have Margaret as your wife.
Yes, you can say that again, John. She's responsible for expanding our business. If not for her, I'd still be a simple farmer.
Although, I'm really sorry. I think I will have to turn down your application for a loan.
What? But why, John?
Because I want to invest in this. I want to be your partner.
Oh.
All right. Cheers.
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 Oh, cheers.
Sir Marco?
Yes?
Can we ask you something? The farmhands want to know if you are going to hire them for this season, or it's about time for them to look for other work.
Oh, don't worry, Ernesto. We are going to require a lot of workers. So please tell them that we will need them all, okay?
That's good news, sir. That will make the other workers settle down.
Oh, Ernesto.
Sir?
Who's that girl?
Oh, that's Emily, the daughter of one of our workers.
Emily?
Yes, sir.
Your name is Emily, right?
Good day, sir.
I'm Marco Montenegro.
I know, sir.
How come you know me?
Well, everyone here in Olivares City knows who you are.
What are you doing here in the farm?
This is the only available work here.
You know, you're not suited to farm work. You should be working in an office, huh?
It's all right, sir. I like working here at the farm. Goodbye, sir. Father, it's been months since Mother died, and I'm sure she wouldn't like to see you in this state.
I'm sure that she would chide me, but she is no longer here. She's gone.
Father, how long will you be like that? That might be the death of you. What about me? You'll leave me alone?
Nothing will happen to me. I'm not going to leave you. Oh, by the way, let me change the subject. Why was Sir Marco talking to you earlier? What did he want from you?
What else?
I want you to stay away from that man.
Father, Sir Marco's reputation is known all over town. Everyone knows he isn't the type of guy who respects women. I'm not going to fall for his tricks. Your daughter's smarter than that.
Yes, my daughter really is smart. It's just too bad that you had to stop schooling. Never mind, though. I'll find a way so that next year you will be able to continue your schooling.
That's not necessary, Father.
No, dear. No. You will go to school. I promise you that this coming year, I'm not going to fail you. You shouldn't be like me. I'm illiterate. I'm stupid. Look what happened. My whole life. I have no choice but to toil another man's land.
No, Father.
Keep in mind that education is important. If you have a college degree, you will not be considered useless. No one can take advantage of you. No matter who they are, they can never step on you.
Hey, where are you going? Why don't I take you home?
Oh, thanks for the offer, but I have to pass by somewhere before going home. Thanks anyway.
Are you sure?
Yes, thank you.
It's been a while since you've invited us out. What's up?
Oh, nothing, buddy. Just work.
That's not what I heard. Rumor has it that you're courting another girl.
What are you talking about?
Some country lass. What? I've heard. She's a worker in the new land that they acquired.
Is she pretty?
Let's not talk about it, buddy. Come on, let's drink up.
Of course he doesn't want to talk about it, because apparently the girl rejected him.
What? Someone has refused Marco Montenegro?
Buddy, I'm disappointed in you. You've already lost your touch.
Let me tell you, gentlemen, it's all a matter of time, okay? This will be a piece of cake. Relax.
To make things interesting, come on.
How
much? Why don't we bet on it?
Let's do it.
Oh, you want to bet? Don't be ridiculous. Are we really betting on such a thing? Come on.
Let's bet 50 bucks on it.
It's just 50 bucks. Do it.
That should be nothing to you.
Yes, I'm in.
50 bucks. All right, I'll call.
That's 50 bucks, all right?
Oh,
agree?
Can you really afford 50 bucks?
No, man.
This has higher alcohol content. How long has that wine been aged, Ernesto?
That's 7 months, madam. But Sir Marco says this wine is not ready yet.
Mom? Dad told me our workers won't get a holiday bonus.
You may go now.
Yes, ma'am.
Marco, you shouldn't question like that in front of our own workers. And to answer your question, yes, they won't receive a bonus.
But Mom, we earned so much this year.
We need a substantial amount for our winemaking business. This is where we will invest our profits.
That's it? So what about our workers?
Well, maybe next year.
Next year.
Marco, what are you doing? You're wiping that so hard. What's the matter? Are you trying to rub the paint off?
Aunt Henya, Mom just told me. She won't give our workers a holiday bonus this coming Christmas. She said she will use the money as capital for the winemaking business, but that's my project. People might think that I'm the reason they won't have a bonus this year.
Not everything ends with your mother. Do you remember what I always tell you, Marco?
That is the blood and sweat of the farmhands that give life to this land.
If you want to, you will surely find a way to make it work.
Thank you.
Thank
Happy
you,
holidays.
Thank you.
Happy holidays.
Happy holidays. Happy holidays, sir.
Happy holidays.
Thank you so much.
I appreciate this, sir.
Let's go.
Happy holidays. Thank you. Happy holidays.
Gloria, what's going on?
Sir Marco is distributing our holiday bonus.
I thought Ernesto said we wouldn't be receiving a bonus from Ma'am Margaret.
She changed her mind. Go and get your share.
Okay.
Emily, for you. Take it. It's your holiday bonus. Come on, take it. Happy holidays.
Thank you, sir.
All right, I'll go ahead.
Sir Marco?
Yes?
Where's your motorcycle?
He sold it so he could give us a holiday bonus.
Father?
Were you waiting for me?
Good grief, I thought it was some ogre.
This ogre is so handsome, though.
You may not look like an ogre, but you behave like one.
What was that?
What? Oh, nothing, sir.
Emily, don't call me sir. Besides, you haven't answered my question yet. Were you waiting for me?
Why would I be waiting for you?
Come on, Emily. Well, let's cut the act already. I know you like me. And I won't give you a hard time, because I like you too.
What? Sir, we are on our own time, right?
Yes.
And here you are in our home.
Yes.
So maybe I can tell you something that I've long wanted to say to you.
What's that?
You're nothing but a conceited jerk! Oh. You think that you're such a good catch that all women would jump at the chance to throw themselves at you?
Hold on there. Modesty aside. Hey, that's what happens all the time. Huh?
Well, I'm different from the others. You think highly of yourself, don't you? You can't fool me. Your charm doesn't impress me at all. And if you think that selling your own motorcycle so that you can distribute money to the people here to make me fall for you, well, it didn't work. You're sorely mistaken.
Wait a minute. I didn't do that because of you. I did it for all the workers. As for my motorcycle, I didn't sell it just to impress you. Now tell me, who between the two of us thinks highly of herself?
I was surprised when you called. What are we doing here, Marco?
Don't you want to see me?
Of course I do. I miss you so much. What about you? Did you miss me? What's wrong?
Nothing.
What's wrong?
Jane, I'm sorry. This is not working out. I'm sorry.
What are you saying? Are you breaking up with me? Have I done something wrong?
No. No.
Then why? Why? Do you need more time? I can give you that, Marco. Just don't leave me. I love you so much.
Jane, listen to me. I don't love you. I'm sorry. I just wanted you to know the truth.
I don't believe you. I know you still love me. Maybe you're just overwhelmed because of all the pressure from our parents. I'm willing to wait.
No, don't wait for me. I won't come back for you. You deserve someone better than me. Listen to me. It's better to get hurt now than wait for the day to come when you get hurt again and again if we insist on this.
Marco, do you know what you're doing? Do you know how this will affect us? As well as our families?
Our families are not part of this. This is just between you and me.
I understand that you're a womanizer, but I just ignore it. Because I know
that in the end I will be the only woman in your life. And I know you will come back for me. Because Marco, it's me. I'm the one you truly love. You do love me, right? Only me?
Herman.
What?
Setting up a cooperative has been one of your good ideas. Our money is earning interest without requiring us to toll for it, right?
Yes. But you know, I hope that someday they will give us our own parcels of land. Our own land. Land that we can call our own here in the Hacienda. So that we can plant the crops that we want.
Is that possible? That seems like a pipe dream.
But what if I try to talk about it with Sir Marco? Maybe he can help us.
You do have some influence over him, Herman. He has fallen hard for your daughter after all.
Don't bet on
That's
it.
That's great, right,
a
Herman?
A lot of young men have tried to court my Emily, it's true. But not one of them has met her approval. That's why, even Sir Marco, I'm sure he'll never succeed either.
Come in.
I'm sorry, Sir Marco. Do you mind if I talk to you?
What is it?
Sir Marco, I'm sorry for what I said to you the other night.
Don't worry about that. Just forget about it. Come here.
Sir?
Come here. Have a taste of this. Huh? Go ahead. Then tell me if it tastes good. Oh, wait. Emily. When tasting wine, you have to firmly hold the stem of the glass. There. With your fingertips. Now, tilt the glass a little so you can see the wine. Check the wine's clarity. And check if the color is good. Take a look, okay? Now smell it. Slowly. Bring the glass to your nose, then inhale about 3 times. You can pick up the wine's aroma on the 3rd time.
It smells like fruit.
Okay, now taste it. Take a sip, then hold it in your tongue before swallowing it. Roll it around. Swallow it. How does it taste?
A bit sour, but delicious. Did you make this?
Yes. You know, Emily, I want to study abroad. I want to become a master of wine. I am pretty sure that my mom won't oppose that.
Why? Don't you get along with your mother?
Oh, you don't know my mom. She wants to be in control, from the business to the way the house is run. But me, I don't like that. I don't want her to control my life, and that's why we argue. I'm just thankful that my Aunt Henya is here, too.
She and Madame Margaret are sisters, but they're as different as night and day.
Uh-huh. You know, Emily, Aunt Henya raised my mom and sent her to school. When they were both still young, my grandfather left them in favor of a very rich woman. That's why my grandmother died early. And that traumatized my mom. So up to now, she doesn't want anyone to ever leave her. Even though she has her own family, she doesn't want Aunt Henya to live away from us. That goes for me, too.
I wouldn't understand anything if you all talked at the same time.
Marissa, give it back to
her. Where is it?
Give her money.
What are you doing here?
I want to take my money from the cooperative, but your father refuses to give it back.
It's our money now.
Wait. I will say this again to all of you. Listen to me carefully. Everyone, the money you gave me is intact. I deposited the money in the rural bank in town. Right now,
I don't
have the time to make the necessary arrangements, so please...
Time? You're probably just planning to run off with our money.
Wait, hold on. Please listen.
To us.
My father is not a thief. Please believe me. So please don't accuse him so readily. We will give your money back to you.
All right, Emily. Because of you, we'll let it aside. But Herman, we really need our money. It's been too long. We need to give it back.
Right. You better make sure.
We need to give that money back. That's so long out of here.
Let's go.
Come on. Father, where's the money?
What happened to the money was, well, I just borrowed it to pay for your mother's hospitalization. I was really intending to pay it all back. But you know what happened.
Wait, Father, I thought you said that back then you were using the money that you saved to pay for mother's medical expenses.
Right. Yes. The money that your mom and I saved, it is all gone too, because we used it to send you to school.
Oh. Father, but why? You shouldn't have done that. You knew I would understand perfectly if you couldn't send me to college. I can always work here anyway. I can be a plantation worker like you.
Wait, no, dear. No, I can't have that. No matter what happens, you can't blame your parents for trying to give you a better future. Do you understand that? I'm really sorry, dear. I'm sorry that you were born unfortunate. Your father is a huge failure.
Father, that's not true at all. You are a very good father to me. And I consider myself the luckiest person in the world because I am your daughter. We will work this out.
I changed my mind, Joseph. I won't invest in your winemaking business anymore.
But I thought everything was settled.
I thought so too. But I have my concerns. Marco is going to handle this business, right?
Yes. You already know Marco is a genius when it comes to winemaking.
And we also know how he likes to play around. He's into sports and all sorts of activities. He lacks focus.
But sir, you know how serious I am when it comes to business.
But I don't know if you will be responsible enough to manage this business and make it successful.
Does this have anything to do with...
Of course not, buddy. This is business. Purely business.
I knew it. Didn't I warn you, Marco? Our business will surely be affected by your breakup with Jane.
No problem. Let's just look for another investor.
Joseph, we've been looking for a long time and no one is interested. All they want is real estate. And I barely even see your sign these days. What's preoccupying you? Another girl? I'm sure that girl is worthless.
You find all women worthless except for Jane.
Exactly. Because Jane is the right woman for you, Mark.
But I don't even love her.
But you have loved Jane before. That's why I know that you can love her again.
It's not that easy, Mom.
Marco, don't be too choosy. You might end up missing chances if you're not careful. And you'll be an old bachelor. Look what happened to your Aunt Henya.
Margaret, that will be enough.
I should probably help Indai with the dishes.
Son, this is the only advice I can give you. The girl you will marry should be of your choice. You have to decide who you will marry. Jane and the business, or the woman you will love forever. Who knows, your mother might be right, and it turns out that the woman is also Jane.
Emily?
Father?
No, slowly, sir. Be careful.
Oh, I know. I know.
Father, what happened? Oh, no.
Emily.
I'm really sorry,
Emily,
sir.
Emily, my dear.
Please, let me take it from
no,
here.
No, leave this to me. Your father's just drunk. Everything okay?
Thank you, Sir Marco.
Sir Marco? Haven't I told you to drop the sir?
Marco.
There. It's easy enough to say, right?
Thank you. Oh,
these are for you. Oh, sorry. Looks like... Oh, they're all ruined. Your dad squashed them on the way here.
They're still lovely anyway. Thank you.
I'll be going.
Marco?
Oh, yes?
Well, just in case you're, free tomorrow, and you're not doing anything in particular, maybe you'd want to join us here for lunch?
Okay. I'll head out now.
Oh, the food is finally ready. Go put it on the table.
Oh, thank you, sir.
Sir Marco is our guest, so make sure he likes our good time.
Oh, taste it.
I cooked that one. Okay. Oh, what are you waiting for? It's time to eat. Go
Should
on.
Should we try this?
There, try that one. That's good.
Hanggang sa dulo ng walang hanggan, hanggang matapos ang kailan pa man, ikaw ang siyang mamahalin at lagi nang sasambahin. Manalig kang di ka naluluha giliw, at kung sadyang siya lang ang iyong asahan mo nga ko'y di hadlang, habang ikaw ay maligaya, ako'y maghihintay.
What does this symbol mean?
It's the symbol for infinity, forever. Just like my love for you, Emily. I love you. I love you, Emily.
I love you too, Marco.
Emily, will you marry me?
Yes, I will. This is the first time I've loved like this, Marco. And I hope that you won't betray my trust in you. Because I'll give everything, my heart and my whole being. Just don't destroy my trust in you, or my heart will never be able to recover.
Emily, I will love you. I will cherish you. I will never betray you.
Maging hanggang sa dulo ng walang hanggan. Walang
Are you absolutely sure about that boy, Marco?
Marco is a good man, Father. Besides, I love him.
I don't have a problem with Marco, dear. I'm just worried because once you marry Marco, Marco's not the only one that you will have to please. You will also have to get along with his entire family. Oh, do you think you'll be able to handle that?
Marco already told me that he'll take care of me, Father.
I hope so, dear. This is the biggest gamble you ever took in your life. I just hope you will end up being the winner.
You replaced Jane with this? Good grief, Marco. What were you thinking?
Mom, I love Emily, so just live with it.
Do you know who this girl is? Huh? She was a stupid girl in my party before. And besides, she's the daughter of one of our workers. She's illiterate.
She finished second year college, so what? What matters to me is that she's smart, she's nice, and she's honorable. That's more important than any college degree.
She's just after your money, I'm telling you.
Stop it, Mom. Will you listen? You can't change my mind. Now, if you don't like her, that's your choice. Just like it's my choice to choose whom I will marry, and that woman is Emily.
Marco is right. He has chosen to marry Emily, not us. Look, we can all live together under one roof, right?
Mom, listen to me. If I cannot change your mind, then that's okay. I will leave this house so I can be with Emily.
What do I have to do to get Emily out of Marco's life?
Margaret, believe me, Emily is a good person. You should leave them be.
Henya, even you? You are taking Marco's side?
No, but everyone can see that you are wrong. Marco has loved Emily for a long time now. Please, just leave them be.
Will you stop it? Don't go around lecturing me like I'm some kid. As a mother, I know what is best for Marco and for my family. You're only saying those things because you're not Marco's mother. That's why you're not concerned, even when he's throwing away his future.
You're right. I am not Marco's mother. But I love him. I love Marco like he is my own son. Margaret. What do you want to happen to Marco? Do you want him to go back to his old ways, flirting from one woman to the next? His life finally has direction, and that is great. And that is only because of Emily. Because he has finally found the only woman he will love.
What do you even know about love, Henya? Nothing. That's why you ended up an old maid.
Stop being Miss Know-It-All. You don't know everything.
Virginia. I would like to apologize for what Margaret said earlier.
It's okay. That's just the way Margaret is. And besides, everything she said is true. I am an old maid who knows nothing about love.
Is that true? Or maybe I've forgotten that a long time ago. You were also in love.
Once. That was back then. A very long time ago. And I told you I didn't love you. Not in that way.
lang siya lang ang iyong mahal. Asahan mong ako'y di hadlang habang ikaw ay maligaya. Ako'y maghihintay maging hanggang sa dulo ng walang hanggan. Maging hanggang sa dulo ng walang hanggan.
Don't be affected by Mom's display. She cannot change my mind. My decision still stands.
But she's right. I'm just a nobody. I'm a mere worker in your plantation. I haven't accomplished anything. What can someone like me offer you?
A lot, Emily. You are important to me. You are my life now. I never want to lose you. If you want, we could get married first thing tomorrow.
Marco, if we're really going to get married, let's not be too hasty. We have to do it the right way.
My daughter has been crying for days now. I guess she's still hurt over what your mother has said.
I'm very sorry, Herman. You can trust me. I will do right by Emily. I will never hurt her. Herman, I want to ask for your help. I don't want her to back off from our wedding because of my mom.
You know, Sir Marco, it was a really big deal. What your mom said to Emily really affected her, because for people like us, who are poor, when the higher class look down on us and label us, when you call us poor people, uneducated, or stupid and ignorant, well, that doesn't sit well with us. So now, Emily feels that she isn't worthy anymore to be your wife.
But if that's the only thing she needs to deal with my mom, then I can help her. If it's okay with you, I can finance your daughter's studies.
Emily will never accept that.
That's why you won't tell her that the money is from me. What matters is for Emily to achieve her dreams, and she will be able to face Mom with her head held high.
Emily, look here. I have a wonderful surprise for you. With this, you can finally continue your schooling.
Where did all that money come from?
Oh, I was able to get some money.
Huh? Then shouldn't you deposit that money on your cooperative's account?
Oh, no, you see...
So that you can replace the money that you took
no,
out?
No, because he wants to,
Who?
He wants to use this
Did that
to...
money come from Markle? Come on, Father.
Let me explain, dear. I didn't ask him for this money. He gave this to me willingly, and he told me to use this for your studies so that you can get a degree. That way you won't feel ashamed to face his
family.
You
still shouldn't have accepted that, Father. We have to return that money to him.
You haven't been joining us for a while, Marco. This past holiday, you didn't even join us for a drink.
I had a lot of things to do. Sorry, guys.
Yes, he was really busy chasing women. Did you get her?
Emily's my girlfriend now. What about it, huh?
This is exactly what I was expecting.
I knew it would happen. Here's my 50.
And here is my bet.
Oh, it's all right, you guys, especially you, Alan. You mentioned that your business is going under, so here's your money. Keep it.
It's only 50 bucks. A bet is a bet, right?
What would you say if I told you that I'm going to marry Emily?
Whoa! Buddy, it looks like you finally found your match.
This better be the last time we talk about that woman, okay?
All right.
Especially you. Here's 100 for you. Your business went bankrupt,
what?
So you better
come
take
on.
That.
Let's just
shut
drink
up.
To that.
I only need a little more to save my business.
That's great.
Madame Margaret?
Are you surprised? Are you expecting my son?
Madam, is there anything that I can do for you?
Stay away from my son, Marco.
Madam, I'm sorry, but we're not doing anything wrong. I really do love your son.
You love Marco? Or you mean to say you love the things my son gives you? I took the time to check on Marco's bank account, and I found out that he recently made a sizable withdrawal. That was for you, right?
But I was going to return.
Don't bother. Consider it my gift for you. Just make sure that you and your father will leave.
I refuse to leave, madam.
It seems that you're forgetting something. This land that you're standing on, this all belongs to me. And anytime I want, I can kick you out of here.
I will never leave Marco.
Marco doesn't love you. You're just a plaything. You are just one of the many girls he had fun with.
No, that's not true. He told me himself that he will never betray me.
And you believed him? Huh. I know you're aware of Marco's reputation when it comes to women. Why? Did you think he has changed because of you? Oh, no.
I am confident of Marco's feelings for me. I know he truly loves me.
Marco only courted you because of a bet with his friends.
That's not true.
Alan?
Ma'am.
I want you to tell this woman the details of your bet with Marco.
We're Marco's friends, and we made a bet regarding you for the amount of $50.
I don't believe any of this.
Tell her the rest of it.
If he makes love to you, that's $50,000. If he takes you to the altar,
will you marry me?
That'll be $500,000.
And, Emily, the bet only mentions the altar. He has no intentions of marrying you. You're pathetic.
Then I will gladly pay their debts to you myself. But Marco should never find out.
You once told me you loved me. Was that true?
How can I ever love someone like you?
You love me, right? Let's get married as soon as possible.